In this video, we're looking at a light ray that undergoes multiple refractions as it transitions from air to water and then water to crown glass. And in parts A and B of the problem, we want to find the refracted angles at each of those steps. And then in part C, we're looking for the total horizontal distance traveled by the ray from the point where it enters the water to the point where it exits the crown glass. So just to index things for Snell's law, I'm going to call the air material 1, the water material 2, and the crown glass material 3. I want the angle of refraction when the ray enters the water. So that's this angle right here. I'll call that theta 2. And then we apply Snell's law. N1 sine theta 1 equals N2 sine theta 2. And we plug in N1, and the index of refraction for air is approximately 1. And we have an incident angle here of 50 degrees. Remember, that's measured with respect to the normal. N2 is 1.33, the index of refraction for water. And then theta 2 is the only unknown left in this equation. So we simply divide by 1.33 and then invert this sine function. And when I run the numbers on this to 3 sig figs, I get 35.2 degrees. Now that angle, theta 2 equals 35.2 degrees, that's going to be the same as the incident angle for the second refraction because these two angles are alternate interior angles. So that's also theta 2. And then I apply Snell's law to the second refraction and get theta 3. So we write down N2 sine theta 2 is N3 sine theta 3. And I plug in the index of refraction for water. So remember, material 2 is the water. Sine of the incident angle onto the crown glass, which is going to be theta 2 or 35.2 degrees. Index of refraction for the crown glass, 1.52. Sine theta 3, which is the only unknown here. So we divide by 1.52 and invert the sine function. And when I run the numbers on this, I get 30.3 degrees. Finally, I want to get the total horizontal distance between the point where the ray enters the water and where it reaches the bottom of the crown glass. If I look at that first refraction, I'm just going to continue the normal line straight down. And then this little line segment is a little contribution to that total horizontal displacement, and I'll call that D1. Well, we know the vertical leg of this triangle is 1.5 centimeters. That's the thickness of that layer of water. And we know the angle theta 2 is 35.2 degrees. And now we're just trying to find the opposite side of a right triangle when we know the adjacent side. Well, the key to that is using the tangent function. The tangent is the opposite over the adjacent. And we can quickly solve that for D1 just by multiplying by 1.5. And I get a horizontal displacement of 1.06 centimeters. Then I do the same thing for D2. And that vertical distance is 2.1 centimeters. The angle is 30.3 degrees. We computed that in part B. And the only unknown there is the opposite side, D2. I multiply both sides by 2.1. And I get 1.23 centimeters additional distance. Finally, I add up these two distances. D is D1 plus D2. And I get a total of 2.29 centimeters of horizontal displacement as the ray travels through both materials. If you find the physics content on Zach's lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.